Yes, good morning everyone. Let me welcome you all again for this class number 3 on transmission and distribution. I wanted to share certain topics today which is related to the transmission and distribution, that is introduction to electrical power system. And we had discussed a few concepts there. So let me share my screen right now. Okay. I hope I'm audible enough. Can anyone just confirm?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. Yes. I think the previous sessions, these are the concepts that we had discussed. Okay. Let me start with page number 1. Okay. So this is the page number 1, what we wanted, what we already discussed previously. And we wanted to highlight all these concepts again to make a revision. All right. So now, what I'm going to see here, we started with the fundamental definition of a circuit and a system. Next, we wanted to highlight regarding the system parameters that are associated with respect to the system. And I wanted to extend the same thing with respect to an electrical power system and the structure associated with respect to the electrical power system. Okay. Now, when I talk about generation, I'll be having the generating station, as we already studied, and we wanted to highlight the transmission of electrical power that is done by the transmission line conductors having a supporting from the transmission line towers, and we have a distribution end that is carried out by the separate distribution station that is there in each and every district or the place, whatever we receive the transmission power, the transmitted power from the transmission lines. Okay, so now I have classified the consumers as both industrial consumers and the residential consumers. So in industrial consumers, there will be a large number of motors of large ratings. Okay. So to meet the requirement of those large loads, or we call it as bulk loads, so we'll be having the higher values of voltages, or the power rating of the machine will be in such a way that it will be having the higher ratings generally. So when I say the term rating, it can be a voltage rating, it can be a current rating, or generally the term rating refers to the power rating of the device or the instrument or the motor that is connected, or the bulk load which is to be connected. Okay. Now, this is the simple structure of the power system what we have studied last time. So what we wanted to highlight is regarding the generation end. Okay. Next, we wanted to highlight regarding the transmission end. Okay. Next, we need to highlight regarding the distribution end. So after the distribution, you will be having a separate section here, which we generally call it as the feeders and service mains. Okay. So feeders, distributors and service mains, that is the topic what we'll be discussing as the class proceeds. Okay. Now, can anyone tell me what is the voltage rating of a generating station, the standard voltage levels? Very good. Now, the 11 kilovolt or the 33 kilovolt is the voltage that is being generated. So we need to go for the step up transformer to transfer the amount of electric power. Okay, the transfer of electric power, it is done with 11 kilovolt, whatever that's written, the 11 kilovolt bar 220 or 132 kilovolt. So these 132 or the 220 kilovolt is called as the standard level of transmission voltage, standard level of transmission voltage, standard level of transmission voltage. So this is what I highlighted previously. So the voltage which needs to be used for transmission of electrical power is done at a standard level of voltage. Okay. Now, can anyone tell me what is the highest value of transmission line voltage that we have achieved? We had discussed in the previous class also. Can anyone? 765. Yeah, 765. We started with 400 kilovolt. Next, we started with 765. The stable operating voltage here in India, is 765 kilovolt. And later, the work is going on with 1200 kilovolt. Okay, so that is purely AC transmission system that we have here. So we generally call it as high voltage AC transmission system. Okay, so we have different types of transmission system also depending on the type of supply that is used for the transmission, that is HVAC and HVDC. We'll discuss more about it as time proceeds. Okay, so this is the simple way in which I can represent, sir, represent an electrical power system. Okay, so you know that once it reaches the distribution end, you will be having, yeah, tell me.
Sir, many of them are waiting to join the class.
Okay, 1 minute, I'll just stop sharing. I think now everyone has joined. I think everyone have joined right now. Can anyone confirm? Yes, Rohan Pujari was there in the lobby. Yeah, I think I had also posted a message that you need to be there in the class at 11. Okay, so see to it that you are not going to do such things from here on. Fine. Okay, let me start sharing again. Okay, now what is meant when you say you need to transmit the higher values of the voltages? Okay, so what do I mean by it is, so why can't the transmission of electrical power be carried out at lower values of the voltage? So why do we need to prefer the higher voltage for transmission of electrical power? So we have certain advantages there in high voltage transmission system, such as lesser conductor material required, increase in the transmission line efficiency, next, reduction in the percentage of the line drop. Okay, so previously we had covered the first point, which is lesser conductor material that is to be required. Okay, so now we had certain like equations which are associated with that. Okay, so that is where we were highlighting more on the transmission conductor material which is to be required. Okay, so let's quickly go through it, the derivation. I think we had certain terminologies what we listed out. So once I have the resistance of the material, that is rho L divided by A. Okay, next, cos phi, which is the power factor of the load. Okay, so next we had the line voltage and the power transmitted in kilowatt. Okay, so next we will be moving on to the concept, whatever that we wanted to discuss. So generally we'll be using copper conductors or copper aluminium alloy conductors as the transmission line conductors. So once I write it as OHTL, which means, can anyone tell me what is OHTL, what I've written here?
Overhead transmission line.
Very good, very good, very good answer. So we generally use it in writing the terminologies like this, like OHTL conductors, which means overhead transmission line conductors. All right, so now I have the first one, which is the lesser conductor material required. Okay, so now it is entirely associated with respect to the weight of the conductor material which needs to be reduced. Weight of the conductor material. Okay, so when I say weight of the conductor material reduced, I'll be going ahead with the first concept, which is the power. The power, which is root 3 VLIL cos phi. Okay, so P equals root 3 VLIL cos phi. Next, I have IL, okay, which is the line current or the load current, whatever that is there. Okay, so how do you represent it? You can represent it by P divided by root 3 VL cos phi. Now, if I want to find out the total copper loss in a three-phase system, okay, now how do you define power loss? P equals V into I. Generally, I define power as V into I, that is I squared into R. Okay, next. It is for a single phase system here. Okay, now if I want to extend the same thing for a three phase system, that would be three times I squared into R. So I here is taken as IL. Okay, so three times IL squared into R. So I can substitute it and I'll be getting this equation, which is P squared rho L divided by VL squared cos squared phi into A. Okay, now once I have this equation, I'll be substituting for total copper losses on the other end, and I want the area of cross section. So this A here represents the area of cross section. Okay, now I have the area of cross section here, and how do I get the volume? How do I get the volume? Generally, it is 3 into A into L. Okay, so 3 into A into L. So is volume a 2-dimension or a 3-dimension quantity? A question is asked to the students. Can anyone in the meeting tell me what do you mean by volume? Like generally, a volume is a 3-dimensional quantity or a 2-dimensional quantity?
3-dimensional, sir.
3-dimensional, exactly. So I have area to be 2-dimensional and a length, which is the length of the conductor. I'll be taking the volume as 3 times A into L. Okay, so 3 times A into L. So this is the total volume of the copper material which is to be required, considering rho, which is the resistivity of the material, L, which is the length of the transmission line conductor, and we have power and the power factor to remain constant. So all these parameters here are said to be the constant terms here. Okay, constant terms. Okay, so that is the reason why we generally call the volume of the material to be required. Okay, volume of the copper material which is to be required, which will be equal to the weight of the copper conductors. So I can certainly have the final equation where weight of the conductor is directly proportional to 1 divided by V squared. Okay, so I just gave you an example where for 132 kilovolt line, so we need a weight of 250 kg, and for a voltage which is 220 kilovolt, so higher than the previous voltage, so we might go for 120 kg or 100 kg of the or 150 kg of copper material which is to be required. Okay, so this was a simple way in which we understood that as the voltage keeps on increasing, the square value of the voltage will be inversely proportional to the weight of the conductor. So as the voltage, system voltage here, so when I say V, it is nothing but the system voltage. System voltage. So system voltage keeps on increasing, the weight of the conductor keeps on decreasing. Okay. Yes. So let's move on to the second concept, that is increase in transmission line efficiency. Increase in transmission line efficiency. Okay, now let me start with the fundamental term here. What do you generally mean by efficiency? Yes, what do you generally mean by efficiency? Okay, let me say, how do you calculate your percentage of marks? I need the session to be interactive. I don't want anyone to be just sitting and turning it on and keeping it quiet. I want the entire session, the complete session, what I take, I want it to be interactive. Okay, what is the transmission line? Let me start first one, which is how do you calculate the percentage? Is Ambika there in the meeting?
Yes, sir.
Ambika, can you tell me how do you define efficiency?
Power output to the power input.
Yes, very good. Power output divided by power input into 100. Why we need to multiply it by 100?
Percentage.
Very good, very good. Now, you have already done some numerical problems in transformers and generators. You would be calculating the efficiency and all. Now, in case of any network or any system, the transmission line efficiency, in case of transmission line towers here, it is also given by power output divided by power input into 100. Okay, so 100, it is generally the representing the transmission line efficiency in terms of the percentage. Okay, now there is one more thing. Is this correct? The equation what I have written there, is it correct? Siddling Swami, is the equation correct?
Sir?
Is this equation correct? Whatever I have written on the whiteboard, is this equation correct?
Sir, if efficiency is equal to 1.
Okay, what do you mean by efficiency equal to 1? It is 100%. Generally, we consider this to be an ideal case. Okay, you would have studied it in ideal transformer or an ideal diode, where the voltage drop or the efficiency of a transformer is said to be equal to unity or 100%. Exactly. Now, we are having a real transformer where power input will be equal to power output plus total losses. Okay, so we say total losses generally. Okay, now I can write out this equation as power output plus this total losses is given as total copper losses. Total copper losses. Okay, can I write it like this? Because once the material is constructed or the conductor is drawn out, so you will be having some losses that is by the material. Fine. So that will be fixed. Now, I want to find out what would be the total copper losses, which is entirely dependent on the value of current. Okay. So it is given for a three-phase system as 3 into I squared into R. Okay. So now I have this power output. Okay. So now I have this power output. So I can write it as power output plus P squared rho L divided by A V squared cos squared phi. Okay, so I can write it as power input will be equal to P plus P squared into rho into L divided by A into V squared cos squared phi. Okay, so this is the equation what we have got for the power input. Okay, so now I can write it like this. Power input will be equal to power plus P squared rho L divided by A into V squared cos squared phi. Okay, now let's move on to the next concept. Can anyone tell me how do you define current density? How do you define current density, J? Yeah, as I told you, I want the session to be interactive. I'll not go ahead at all if it is not interactive. It would be quite easy for me to proceed with the steps. Okay, so unless and until you don't understand, it would be very difficult for me to go ahead with the syllabus. Okay, I want everyone to understand clearly what I'm teaching. There is no point in certainly posting the recorded videos and all. Okay, so I want you to be interactive as much as possible. Yes, do I? Yes. Yes, Himanshu. Himanshu?
Yes, sir.
Yes, Himanshu, how do you define current density? Okay, J will be equal to? What is it? Okay, so J, yeah, Himanshu failed to give the answer. So it would be current density that will be equal to the value of current flowing in the conductor per unit area. Okay, so that is how you can define the current density J, which will be equal to I by A. Okay, now very important concept here. So I'll replace A with I by J. Okay, now I'll replace the equation in power input as A will be equal to I divided by J. Okay. Now that power input will be equal to P plus P squared rho L divided by V squared cos squared phi. Okay. Into that is J by I. Okay. So this A which was there, it was 1 by A. 1 by A can be written as J by I. Okay. 1 by A can be written as J by I. Okay, so now what I can do here is P plus P squared rho L divided by V squared cos squared phi into J, okay, into J, okay. So how I can write this current? Current, how I can write this current? P divided by root 3 V cos phi, root 3 V cos phi. Now, how I can write it? Into root 3 V, root 3 cos phi into V divided by P. Okay, so I replaced it with J by I for the area of cross section, and I replaced this with the value of current. Okay, now let us move on to the next one, which is the final equation what we wanted. Okay, so power input will be equal to P times 1 plus root 3 rho L divided by V into cos phi. V into cos phi. Okay, so this is the final equation what you are going to get it. Okay, so I want each and everyone to make a note of the concepts whatever I am teaching. Okay, it's for your benefit. Next, how do you define transmission line efficiency? How do you define a transmission line efficiency? We generally call it as eta transmission line, which is transmission line efficiency, which is given by power output divided by power input into 100. Power output divided by power input into 100. Now, certainly the power output is taken as P divided by power input is P times 1 plus root 3 into rho into L divided by V into cos phi. Okay, now I can cancel this out, and what I'll do is I can write the transmission line efficiency as this one. So eta transmission line, eta transmission line will be equal to 1 divided by 1 plus root 3 rho into L divided by V into cos phi. Okay, so V into cos phi. Now, using the binomial theorem, I want you to go through this binomial theorem concept. Using binomial theorem, I can write eta transmission, line, which will be equal to 1 minus root 3 rho L, okay, rho L, okay, so divided by V into cos phi, okay, rho L into V into cos phi, okay. So this is how I can write it as 1 minus rho into L divided by V into cos phi. Okay, now what did you understand from this equation? What I've written it in box, what did you understand from this equation? So we used binomial theorem. Okay, so it is a simple theorem. What it is, 1 minus x plus x squared by 2, that 2 factorial, which is there like that. Okay, so we'll only take the first term, 1 minus x. So this is 1 divided by 1 plus x here. So it can be written as this. Okay, so 1 minus x will be written like this. Now, using the binomial theorem, we found out this equation, which is transmission line. Okay, now what happens when the voltage keeps on increasing? What happens to the voltage when it is keeps on increasing? So look at this equation and do conclude what you understand. So with the increase in the voltage, the transmission line efficiency also increases. Okay, so observing the equation, with the increase in voltage, the transmission line efficiency, also increases. Okay, so this is what I wanted to conclude, where with the increase in the value of the voltage, the transmission line efficiency will also increase. Okay, so the third concept, which is reduction in the line drop. Okay, we have reduction in the line drop. we have reduction in the line voltage drop. Okay, so we have reduction in the line voltage drop here. Okay, now what I wanted to show here is in general. So how do you define voltage drop? How do you define voltage drop? Nirmita is there in the meeting? Is Nirmita there in the meeting? How do you define the voltage drop in general? It is defined as I into R. Okay, it is defined as I into R. Now, once when I say it is defined as I into R, I can write it as I, that is resistance can be defined as rho L divided by A. Okay, now, so this A can also be represented as current density equation, which is I into rho L into J divided by I. Okay, so what are the things that get cancelled? So that is J rho L, J rho L. Okay, so that is the line drop, what we can express in terms of voltage drop, line voltage drop, in terms of line voltage drop, in terms of line voltage drop. Now, to express the line drop in percentage, to express the line voltage drop, line voltage drop in percentage, voltage drop in a percentage. So how you can write the percentage? For example, you have a value of the voltage which is taken as the denominator term. So what would be the line drop what you can expect? J rho L into 100. So that is the line voltage drop which you need to express in terms of the percentage. Okay, now what do you conclude here? What do you conclude? So with the increase in the value of voltage, the percentage line drop, okay, so percentage line drop decreases. Okay, so with increase in system level voltage or system voltage or system line voltage, so system voltage, the percentage line drop decreases. The percentage line drop decreases. Okay, so this is what I wanted to mean here in case of the line drop. So whatever we discussed till now, that is the advantages of high voltage transmission, that is first one, the lesser conductor material which is required. Second one, increase in the transmission line efficiency. Okay, next one, reduction in the percentage of line drop. So all those concepts have been discussed with the help of relevant equations, and we concluded that there is an advantage of lesser material, copper conductor material, which is required, that is the volume of the copper material. Okay, next one, we wanted to highlight regarding the transmission line efficiency, that is increase in the transmission line efficiency. Next, we wanted to find out the line voltage drop. Okay, so with increase in the system voltage, the line voltage drop or the line drop will certainly decrease. Okay, let's move on to the next topic, that is interconnection of distribution system. Okay, very important concept here, because as an engineer in any distribution station, if you go there, so this is the basic understanding or basic representation of a distribution system. Okay, so now we have received the transmission line power to the distribution station. So now how we are going to distribute this power, okay, whatever the electrical power that we have received over residential consumers, and some of them will be certainly having small scale industries and all, so that type of distribution of electrical power to those places have also need to be carried out. So let us understand how we are going to do the distribution of electrical power and what are the components that are being involved in distribution of the power in a distribution substation. So we generally use the term here, which is distribution station, which means distribution substation. Okay, so let me write down here components of a distribution substation. Distribution substation. Okay, now let me give a representation here. Now we generally have this local substation here. Okay, we have the local substation here and we have the consumers. So let me draw a house here. Okay, so let me draw a simple house to represent the flow of power from the local substation to the house. Now you cannot connect the direct local substation to the house or whatever the apparatus that is having, so to the meter board here. So we generally don't connect it directly to the local substation. So what we do here, we have certain components that are present there in the distribution station. That is the first one, we generally call it as the feeders. Okay, so we call it as feeders. Okay, so next we have distributors. We have distributors. Next, third one, we have service mains. Okay, so third one, we have service mains. So it is impossible to connect the local substation, which is LSS, what I've written here, directly to the residential consumers. Okay, highly impossible to connect it. The equipments, whatever, we directly take the local substation voltage. So the equipments, whatever that is connected at our home, will not be able to sustain the voltage levels and all. Okay, so it would be better that we have a network from the local substation, such that the safe amount of voltage or the safe level of voltage is to be carried out or it's to be received by the residential consumers. Okay, so let us understand the first one, which is the distribution system. Okay, so how do you generally define a distribution system? Anyone okay would like to answer? How do you define a distribution system? A simple definition. How do you define the distribution system? Okay, now, so I can define it like this. So that part of the power system, which distributes electric power, for local use is known as distribution system. Very important definition here, how you are going to define a distribution system. So in case if you go to any interview, so they might just generally ask you, how do you define a distribution system? Okay, so in case if you say that a transmission and distribution, I'm good at transmission and distribution subject. Okay, so they will generally ask you the question, what do you mean by a distribution system? What do you mean by a transmission system and all? Okay, so a simple definition, what you can highlight is, so which is a part of a power system which distributes electric power for local use or local usage is known as distribution system. Okay, now I certainly said that it is a part of the power system, electrical power system. So now I have the local substation. Okay, so once I receive it from the transmission line towers, I have the local substation. Okay, so now I have the consumer meters also, which is generally the energy meter, what you see at your home. Okay, so now coming to the components of it, so how I can generally write it with the help of a diagram. So I just generally call it as local substation here. Now I can have the feeders. Okay, so I can have the feeders that are there. So I can certainly have the feeders like this. Generally, I'm representing it. You can represent it by any means. So let me represent it by a simple square. Okay, so now what you generally mean from the local substation. Okay, I think it is not meeting the ends. Okay, never mind. Okay, so fine. So you have the feeders like this. Okay, so now from the local substation. Okay, so let me mark the areas as A, B, C and D. So it is more or less like the points what I have connected the feeders. Okay, so this a point here from the local substation to the points A, B, C and D are generally called as the feeder. Okay, so generally called it, we generally call it as a feeder. Okay, so now how we are going to define the feeder. Okay, so how we are going to define the feeder. Okay, so first one, the definition of a feeder. Okay, so as you see that it is from the local substation to the point B, A, B, C and D. Okay, correct. Now, a feeder is a conductor which connects the local substation or the local station to the area where the power is to be distributed. Let me write here, a feeder is a conductor. A feeder is a conductor which connects the substation, which connects the substation to the area where power is to be distributed, where power is to be distributed. Power is to be distributed. Okay, so now what you see here from the local substation, I have connected it to area number A, B, C and D. Okay, so I have many such areas where there is a necessity of the electrical power which needs to be distributed from the local substation to the all the areas. Okay, so generally if I have four areas, I can represent it by four points, or if I have five areas, I can represent it by five points and all. Fine. Now, from this local substation to the point B or point A, okay, so now you don't have any such local. Students, I would like to stop the class right now. 1 minute.